Are you afraid of being bored on an upcoming camping trip? Well, stop it. There are tons of things to do camping, and in this video, I'm gonna give you 18 ideas of different things that you can do camping so that you don't get bored. Okay, and I've split those things up into three different categories. So there's some active ideas, there's some relaxed or more laid back ideas, and then there's some touristy ideas. So no matter who you are and what you like to do camping, I think you're gonna find something in this video that you find interesting or useful. So before we jump in, I just wanna let you know that this video you're watching right now is actually the first video in a series we're starting on our channel that's all about helping people who are beginners to camping or who are inexperienced camping get started. And so if you're kind of new to the camping game, then I encourage you to subscribe to this channel and to check out the playlist on our YouTube channel, which is called Camping for Beginners, okay? You're gonna find some resources and videos there that could be really helpful to you. So with that, let's dive in with the first idea. The first few ideas we're gonna go through here are all from the active category, okay? And so for idea number one, this is gonna be go and use a stand-up paddleboard, okay? If you haven't used a stand-up paddleboard before out on a lake or a river or even on the ocean, it's a ton of fun, okay? So I'll also group in with this idea, you could go canoeing or kayaking or something of that nature, but if you haven't done the stand-up paddleboard, I highly encourage you to give it a try. Idea number two is a fun and active thing that you can do even if you're not close to a body of water like a lake or a river, and that would be to go for a bike ride. I love going on bike rides, and if you think that's something you could enjoy too, why not do it while you're on a camping trip? Idea number three is a great one you can do if you're going with a group of people or if you're kind of have a large group of family that's going on a camping trip together, and that's to play some organized sports. So personally, I love to play Ultimate Frisbee. If you have enough people to do that, you could do it too. Or you could do things like play football or maybe play volleyball. Sometimes campsites will have like a volleyball area or have the facilities to play these different organized sports. So if you've got the people and you have the space to do it, then you could try to do one of those. Idea number four is gonna be one of my favorites on the list, and that is to go hiking. Hiking is one of the best ways to kind of see the scenery and get a sense for the place that you're in. And so if you're on a camping trip, look at the different trails that you have available that are nearby. Maybe you can go on a day hike or even just a couple hour hike. That's a great thing to do. Idea number five is one that's kind of been growing over the last several years and something that I've gotten into over the last couple of years, and that's to play frisbee golf. If you haven't played frisbee golf before and you're going on a camping trip, look to see if there's a frisbee golf course somewhere near you and give it a shot. It's a lot of fun. I like doing it. Maybe you will too. For idea number six, we're gonna be transitioning into the relaxed category, which are gonna be some things that you can do that are kind of lower key, more laid back. So idea number six is going to be go fly fishing. So you could do any type of fishing, but I personally really like to go fly fishing. There's a whole different type of technique and art that goes along with it, and if you wanna try a new hobby, then fly fishing might be something to look into. Number seven is a bit easier to get started with, and that is to play yard games. So this would be something like cornhole, or bocce ball, or ladder ball. There's all these different types of yard games that you can play if you have a little bit of open space. And so if you have some of those yard games already, why not throw them in your car and take them on your next camping trip? Idea number eight, this might sound a little bit cheesy, but take a guitar and play some campfire songs. You don't have to sing along if you don't want to, but even just kind of strumming a guitar or finger picking on a guitar or a ukulele while you're at a campsite, especially around the campfire, can be a lot of fun. I've done it myself and I enjoy it. Idea number nine is really, in my opinion, a camping classic, and that is to play card games. Okay, and I think in particular, the card game that is best for camping trips is a game called Euchre. Euchre is kind of a regional card game that's most popular in the Midwest US. And if you haven't played Euchre before, I highly encourage you, go and Google it, learn how to play it on your next camping trip. There you go, that's number nine. Number 10 is a great one, especially if you have a bit more downtime or you're on a longer camping trip, and that is to read a book. Take a book along, especially if you have one that is kind of more like relaxed or maybe a fiction story that you've been wanting to read for a while. That could be a great thing to do while you're on a camping trip. Number 11 is going to be to cook something awesome, all right? And I think this one is one that can be a little bit underrated sometimes. And I know when you're at home and you're not on a trip, it can be tough to kind of go all out and cook some awesome, spectacular meal. But when you're camping, you probably have a little bit more time on your hands. Plus, you have the added challenge of either cooking over a fire or just not having all of the different tools and resources you have at home. So it can be really fun to just go really big and try to cook at least one like awesome outdoor camping meal. So you could do like steaks over the campfire, you could try to do something in a Dutch oven. And if you want some ideas for different recipes you could try while camping, we have a whole playlist about different camping and cooking over the fire recipes, so you can check that out. We'll put a link to that playlist in the description of this video so you can check it out. Now, number 12 is a great one if you're on this channel, because it's to learn an outdoor skill, right? And that's a big part of what this whole channel is about, is talking about outdoor skills and helping people to learn new outdoor skills. And so this could be something like learn knot tying, fire building, maybe you want to learn how to use a compass. If you want to do any of those things while you're on a camping trip, could be a great time to start picking it up. Now, number 13 is to make something. Now, this will depend a little bit on your interests and the type of thing that you're into, but this could be something as adventurous as trying to make a raft or a trebuchet entirely out of the materials and the logs and things that you can find around the campsite and some rope or cord that you brought with you. And then to the other side of the spectrum, it could be something more laid back and subdued, like trying to sketch a hummingbird. Or maybe trying to pick up whittling and make something out of a stick with your pocket knife. So there's a wide range of things that it could be, but at the end of the day, it kind of comes down to do something creative and try to make something with your hands. Number 14 is one that some members of my family are really into. I'm not into it as much, but some people really, really love to do this, and that is bird watching. Bird watching is something that you can do in a lot of areas around the world. And it's something that is interesting. It is interesting to do, kind of watching a bird, seeing what it does, and there are all different types of birds that you can see. And yeah, so if you're interested in that sort of a thing, then that could be a good one to try. For number 15, we're gonna be transitioning into our final category, which are kind of touristy things that you can do. And so exactly what this looks like can depend on the different places that you are or where exactly you're going camping. So these ideas may be more or less relevant for you, or they might just look different depending on where exactly it is you're going camping. So number 15 is gonna be go and visit a nature center or a visitor center at like a local park. So this could be a national park, this could be a state park, or this could be some similar place, right, where you can go and learn and read those wonderful signs with all of the information, see the displays, that sort of thing. I love going to visitor centers, especially at national parks, and when people go there with me, they might even get annoyed because I like to read all of the information on the signs. So anyway, it can be great to go to those, go and visit a visitor center in your area or one that's close by. Number 16 now is to go and eat something local, okay? So especially if you're traveling, you're going someplace new when you're going on a camping trip, then this can be a great one. So for example, say you're going camping in Florida, then you might wanna go and get some citrus, right? They've got grapefruit in Florida, so you might wanna try that out. If you're going camping in Wisconsin, then maybe you wanna try some cheese curds, which I hear are very good in Wisconsin. I don't think I've actually had cheese curds in Wisconsin, but they're very famous there. So those are some ideas of things you can do. Just go and try to eat something that's famous locally or that is a local specialty, and it's just fun to eat, so why not do it? Number 17 now is a little bit interesting, I think, and that's to go buy a souvenir of some kind. So I personally have a huge collection of little hat pins, okay, like the little lapel pins that you can find in some places, and I have them from national parks and different places all over the country, and I've even bought some in other countries as well, and so it can be cool just to have a little souvenir, or if you want to start a collection, you might think about doing that. Now, number 18, the final one on this list, is to look up or try to find the most spectacular view that you can find in the area around your camping. So depending on where you are, this might be a big overlook on some mountain, this might be the Grand Canyon, right? Or it might just be a pretty trail that's through the forest in an area close to your campsite. So whatever the best view, the best scene is that you can find around your campsite, go and find it. That has been our 18 ideas of things to do camping. I hope that you found this helpful, and if you have, or if you've at least found it interesting, please hit the like button for us. That helps other people find our videos. And if you do like outdoors and camping things, especially especially if you're a beginner and you want to get into camping, I invite you to subscribe to our channel. We post new videos like this one here on the channel every week. So with that, hope to see you back here for the next one. Bye, guys.